Hi there everyone, my name is Arifila Ramadhani. Today we are taking a walk through history by exploring the life of Hari Darmawan. Join me as we uncover the untold stories and remarkable achievements of this influential figure.
Hari Darmawan was born on May 27, 1940. He is an Indonesian national entrepreneur who is the founder of the leading retail chain store Matahari Department Store and a popular tourist attraction in Cisarua, Bogor, namely Taman Wisata Matahari. Hari Darmawan, maybe you never know who this man, but I'm sure you know the brand he founded, namely Matahari Department Store. But did you know that Matahari is not owned by Hari Darmawan family, but is Multipolar? Who is behind Multipolar? Namely, Daryadi family, the owner of the Lippo Group. Some people say that Matahari was released from Hari Darmawan's hands because of a strange transaction with the Lippo Group. How could Matahari fall into the hands of the Lippo Group? And how does Lippo geniusly extract extraordinary value from Matahari through the stock market? Okay, let's start. The forerunner of the Matahari department store can be drawn to a small shop called Mickey Mouse, which is located in Pasar Baru, Central Jakarta. In 1950, a man migrated from Makassar. Hari Darmawan moved to Jakarta to try his luck. Hari met Anayanti, who was the daughter of the Mickey Mouse shop owner, and married him in 1958. At the age of 19 years, Hari was given the responsibility to manage a 150 square meter shop. The shop has two floors. The top floor is for his wife to sell clothes, and the bottom floor is for their family who sells imported children's clothes, and also made by his wife called MM Fashion. The shop was not given by the in-laws for free, but had to pay in installments of 1 million per month if he wanted to own it. Hari admitted that he was trying to manage Mickey Mouse efficiently to generate profits. The profits are slim, but if the transactions are frequent, the profits will be big. With this management, the Mickey Mouse shop is growing rapidly, and his in-laws, who were impressed, then sold the shop to Hari. Today's business progress made him interested in developing his business further. Hari opened two new businesses in the 1970s, and Mickey Mouse shop branched too in 1971. The name Mickey Mouse was later changed to MM Fashion, which was maintained until 1988. In 1972, with bank loan capital, Hari bought a shop called The Zot. The Zot was one of the largest department stores in Pasar Baru, 6 times larger than Mickey Mouse shop, but was experiencing financial difficulties. This shop, which is close to his shop, has always been considered a tough competitor. Hari changed the name to The Zone, which in Dutch means Matahari in Indonesian. So the origin of the name Matahari comes from a Dutch department store, which translates as Matahari. Initially, Matahari only had one shop. However, since 1977, Hari decided to expand his shop and set a target of adding one branch every year. This plan only started running in 1980, and Matahari opened its first branch in Bogor. In the 1990s, Matahari continued to open branches in various cities. Indonesia's economy also grew rapidly at the time, providing a tailwind for the growth of Matahari retail stores. Matahari has also become the number one retail company in Indonesia. Hari imitates the operations of various retailers in various countries. After returning from his visit to Japan, Hari introduced the barcode concept, which was then implemented in all Matahari outlets. Hari also built customer service in each shop. Because the number of shops he managed is increasing, Hari also unites the branches of Matahari that it has. PT Matahari Putra Prima Tbk was founded on March 11, 1988. 6 years later, Matahari Putra Prima took the floor on the Jakarta Stock Exchange and the Surabaya Stock Exchange. Matahari at the time had 38 branches in 60 cities, with market share at 55%. Seeing the rapid economic growth day by day, Hari want to open up to 1,000 Matahari branches throughout the world. In 1990, Matahari developed a new retail model. Associated with entertainment venues, Matahari branches are equipped with supermarkets, playgrounds such as Time Zone, record stores, bookstores, hardware stores, and so on. Maybe this is the first modern mall concept initiated by Matahari. I still remember when I was little, when my family asked me to go to the mall, they said to the Matahari, not the name of the mall. That's how strong the image of Matahari was at the time. In 1996, Matahari already had 27,000 employees with sales of 1 trillion rupiah a year. In 1997, Matahari already had 84 branches in 30 cities in Indonesia. Everything seems to be going well, business continues to grow, and Matahari is successful. However, in 1997, the benefactor surprisingly decided to sell his majority stake in PT Matahari Putra Prima to the Lippo Group. Some interpreted that Hari sells because its growth in 1996 had fallen by 30%, and there were concerns about foreign competitors, so it needed a stronger partner. Some said at the time he was forced to sell Matahari to Lippo because he was caught in debt from Lippo Bank, but I didn't find this account in the 1997 or 1998 financial statements. There were also those who say that Hari said that he had to take care of his wife because Yanti and his youngest son were seriously ill, so Hari difficult to manage his business because he always in Singapore. In early 1997, Hari moved Matahari's head office to the Matahari Tower in Lippo Karawaci. His office move was then accompanied by a stock swap or share exchange. Hari received 10% of Multipolar shares under PT Haritama Bhakti Persada. Meanwhile, Multipolar held 48 of Matahari shares, which later increased to 60% and become controller. LPPF, which has the name PT Matahari Department Store Tbk, is actually not the real Matahari. The real Matahari is PT Matahari Putra Prima Tbk, which has the code MPPA. And this LPPF will be related to the story of how Lippo took extraordinary profits. So, LPFF is a financing company or with the name PT Lippo Pacific Finance, which had an IPO in 1989. That's why the stock code is LPPF, which is an abbreviation of its name. LPPF was initially a holding company for other companies in the Lippo Group such as Lippo Bank, Lippo Insurance, Multipolar, and so on. In 1998, LPPF switched from a financing business to another financial company, then changed again to become a general investment and trading company. In 1999, the name changed to PT Pacific Utama Tbk, which only operates in investment. Several of its assets were released, and it only has one subsidiary as well as several minority investments in several other companies. September 2009, MPPA announced that it would transfer its Matahari assets to LPPF MPPA, consisting of various retail networks. One of them is Matahari, so Matahari wants to be spin off or separated into LPPF because it wants to restructure. 25 November 2009, MPPA was completely transferred to LPPF in a transaction amounting to 420 billion rupiah. In 2010, MPPA announced that CVC Capital Partners Asia Truth Mido would buy 98% of LPPF shares and almost all. The shareholders are 20% MPPA and 80% CVC. On 1 April 2010, LPPF was under new ownership, namely Mido. On 19 May 2010, Mido's ownership rose to 98%. On 19 May 2010, Mido's ownership rose to 98%. In September 2011, Mido merged with LPPF. LPPF ownership became 98%. On 8 March 2013, Mido drove the Asia Color Company, sold LPPF shares to the Multipolar Market. Based on the information sold on March 13, 2013, Asia Color sold its shares to MLPL for 2,216 rupiah of a share. Meanwhile, the market price is 4,200 rupiah. In 2015, there were no longer any Asian Color comps holding LPPF shares. Public ownership rises to 71%. Asia Color excited by selling its shares to the public, 14 until 17,000 rupiah. In 2018, it was recorded that Multipolar held 17% of LPPF shares. LPPF share price rose from 200 silver coin in 2009 to 20,000 in 2015 when CVC selling shares to the public. What is the fate of Mr. Hari Darmawan? Hari Darmawan was found tragically dead in the Ciliwung River, Cisarua District, Bogor on March 10, 2018, and no one knows the cause. Just like no one knows the reason why the son was released to Lippo.